Number 7. Given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Recorded on August 7th, 1973, in London, England.
Translation. Now I am confused about my duty and have lost all composure because of weakness. In this condition, I am asking you to tell me clearly what is best for me. Now I am your disciple and a soul surrendered unto you. Please instruct me.
This is very important verse in Bhagavad Gita. It is a turning point of life. Karpanna dosa, miserly, dosa means fault. When one does not act according to his position, that is fault, and that is called miser. So everyone has got his natural propensities, svabhava. Jasya hi jasya svabhavasya tasya asu duratikram. Svabhava, natural propensities. It is a common example it is given that jasya hi jasya svabhavasya tasya natural propensities. It is a common example it is given that jasya hi jasya svabhavasya tasya natural propensities. It is a common example it is given jasya hi jasya svabhavasya tasya natural propensities. It is a common example it is given jasya hi jasya svabhavasya tasya natural propensities. It is a common example it is given jasya hi jasya svabhavasya tasya karpanna dosa. So in the animal life it is not possible to change one's nature, which is given by the material energy, prakriti, prakriti kriyamana. Karanam gunasanga sab, karanam gunasanga asa sadasad janma junishu. Why all living entities are part and parcel of God? Therefore, originally, the characteristic of the living entity is as good as God. Simply, it is a question of quantity. Quality is the same. Quality is the same. Mama Ivangsu Jiva. The same example, if you take a drop of sea water, the quality, the chemical composition is the same, but the quantity is different. It is a drop and the sea is vast ocean. Similarly, we are exactly of the same quality as Krishna. We can study why people say God is impersonal. If I am of the same quality, yeah, God is also person. How he can be impersonal? If qualitatively we are one, then as I feel individually, so why God should be refused individuality? This is another nonsense. The impersonalist rascals, they cannot understand what is the nature of God. In the Bible also it is said, man is made after God. You can study God's quality by studying your quality or anyone's quality. Simply the difference is, the quantity is different. I have got some quality, some productive capacity. We also produce, every individual soul is producing something, but his production cannot be compared with the production of God. That is the difference. We are producing one flying machine. We are taking very much pride that now we have discovered this Sputnik, it is going to the moon planet. But that is not perfect, it is coming back. But God has produced so many flying planets, millions and trillions of planets, very heavy, heavy planets. Just like this planet is carrying so many big, big mountains, sea, but still it is flying. It is floating in the air just like a cotton swab. This is God's power. Gama Vishya, in the Bhagavad Gita you will find, Aham Dharayami Ojasa, who is sustaining all these big, big planets. We are explaining gravity. And in this Shastra we find that it is being carried by Shankarsan. So the quality is the same, but the quantity is different. So because the quality is same, so we have got all the propensities as God has, as Krishna has. Krishna has got loving propensities with his pleasure potency, Srimati Radharani. Similarly, because we are part and parcel of Krishna, we have also got this loving propensity. This is Svabhav. But when we come in contact with this material nature, Krishna does not come into the contact of the material nature. Therefore Krishna's name is Achyuta. He never falls down. But we are prone to fall down. To be under the prakriti kriyamana. We are now under the influence of prakriti. Prakriti kriyamana. Gunai karmani sad. As soon as we fall down under the clutches of this prakriti, material nature, which means prakriti is composed of three qualities, goodness, passion and ignorance. So we capture one of the qualities. That is the cause, karanam, guna-sanga. Guna-sanga means associating with different qualities. Guna-sanga, asya, jiva-asya, the living entity, that is the cause. One can ask, if the living entity is as good as God, why one living entity has become dog and one living entity has become God, demigod? Brahma. That the answer is karanam. The reason is guna-sanga asya asya jivasya guna-sanga. Because he is associating with a particular guna. Satagun, rajagun, tamagun. So these things are described very vividly in Upanishad. How guna-sanga acts. Just like a fire. There are sparks. Sometimes the parts fall down from the fire. Now, there are three conditions of the fire spark falling down. If the spark falls down on dry grass, then it can immediately ignite the grass, the dry grass. If the spark falls down on ordinary grass, then it burns for some time, then again it becomes extinguished. But if the spark falls down on the water, immediately extinguished. The fiery quality. So those who are captured by the satogon, they are intelligent, they have got knowledge, just like Brahma. And those who are captured by the rajogon, they are busy in material activities. And those who have captured tamogun, they are lazy and sleepy. These are the symptoms. Tamogun means they are very lazy and sleepy. Rajagun means very active, but active like monkey. Just like monkey is very active, but they are all dangerous. As soon as monkey will never see inactive. Whenever it will sit down, it will be that. So, these are activities, foolish activities. But when one is in goodness, he is sober, he can understand what is the value of life, how one should live, what is the aim of life, what is the goal of life. The goal of life is to understand Brahma. Brahma janati iti brahmana. Therefore, the good quality means the brahmana. Similarly, kshatriya. They are guna-karma vibhags. Guna. Guna has to be taken into account. Sri Krishna therefore said, chatur-varnam maya system guna-karma vibhags. We have captured some kind of goal. It is very difficult. But we can immediately transcend all gunas. Immediately. How? By bhakti yoga process. Sagunana samati tayitana brahma bhuyaya kalpata. If you take the bhakti yoga process, then you are no longer influenced by either of these three qualities, goodness, passion, and ignorance. That is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Mancabhyabhicharini bhakti yogina jasrivati. Anyone who is engaged in the devotional service of Krishna, of Bhabhicharini, without any deviation, staunch, devout attention, such person, māñca-bhyā-vicārini yogina, māñca-bhyā-vicārini yogina bhajate ma, sagunāna samatitvai. Immediately he began transcendental to all the qualities. So devotional service is not within this material quality. They are transcendental. Bhakti is transcendental. Therefore, you cannot understand Krishna or God without bhakti. Bhaktyamama vijana. Only bhaktyamama vijana. Otherwise, it is not possible. Bhaktyamama vijana ki javan jaschami tattva. Reality. In reality, if you want to understand what is God, that you have to adopt this bhakti process, devotional service. Then you transcend. Therefore, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Narada says that taktva sadharmam charanam bhujam hari. If anyone, even by sentiment, gives up his occupational duty according to guna, that is called sadharma. Sadharma means one's duty according to the quality he has acquired. That is called sadhana. The brahmana, kshatriya, vaishya, shudra, they are divided guna-karma-vibhaga by guna and karma. So here Arjuna says that katpanna dosa apahata sabhava. I am kshatriya. He understands that I am doing wrong. I am refusing to fight. Therefore it is katpanna dosa, miserly. Miserly means I have got some means to spend, but if I don't spend, this is called miser, kripanata. So kripanata, there are two classes of man, Brahman and Shudra. Brahman and Shudra. Brahman means he is not miser. He has got the opportunity, great asset of this human form of body. Many millions of dollars worth, this human. But he is not using it properly. Simply seeing it, how beautiful I am. Just spend your beauty, utilize your asset, the human, that is Brahman, to be liberated. Etat vidityaja prayati sa brahmana. One who knows. Therefore, Prahlad Maharaj says, durlabhaga manusana janma, adhruvam arthadam. He was preaching amongst his class friends. He was born in a demonic family, Hiranyakashipu. And his class friends also, of the same category. So Prahlad Maharaj was advising them, my dear brothers, let us cultivate Krishna consciousness. So other boys, what do they know about Krishna consciousness? Prahlad Maharaj is liberated from the very birth. So they say, what is this Krishna consciousness? They could not understand. So he was convincing them, durlabhaga manusanga janma tadopi adhruvam arthadam. This human body is durlabham. Lankhasu durlabham idam bhavushambhavad. This human form of body is a great concession given by the material nature. People are so miscreant and foolish. They do not understand what is the value of this human form. They engage this body for sense gratification like cats and dogs. The Shastra therefore says, no, this human form of body is not meant for spoiling like the hogs and dogs. Nāyaṁ dīha, dīha bhājāṁ nilopi. Everyone has got a body, material body. But niloke, in the human society, this body is not to be spoiled. Nayam, ayam deha, deha bhajang niloke, kastana kaman arhati virbhujangi. This human form is simply working uselessly hard day and night for sense gratification. This is the business of the hog and dog. They are doing also the same thing. Whole day and night working hard simply for sense gratification. So, therefore, in the human society, there must be a system of division that is called varnasamdha, that is Vedic civilization. That is real called Arya Samaj. Arya Samaj does not mean to become rascal and fool and deny the existence of God. No. That is anarja. Just like Krishna rebuked Arjuna, anarja justam. You are talking like anarja. One who is not Krishna conscious is anarja. Arja means who is advanced in Krishna consciousness. So really arja saman means Krishna conscious person. Otherwise bogus. Bogus arja saman. You hear from the Bhagavad Gita, I say, Krishna says, Arjuna, rebuking, because he was refusing to fight, because he does not know what is his duty. Again, Arjuna is admitting here that katpanna dosho pahatasvabhava. Yes, I am anarj, I become anarj, because I have forgotten my duty. So, actually, Arjuna Saman means Krishna conscious society. International Society for Krishna. There is Arjuna. Not bogus. So here Arjuna is explaining, putting himself, yes, katpanna dosha, because I am forgetting my duty. Therefore, avata sabhava, I am bewildered in my natural propensities. A Kshatriya should be always active. Whenever there is a war, there is fight, they must be very much enthusiastic. A Kshatriya, if another Kshatriya says, I want to fight with you, he cannot refuse. Yes, come on, fight, take sword, immediately come on. That is Kshatriya. Now he is refusing to fight. Therefore, he can understand, he can stand this side, not in front. He is forgetting his duty, Kshatriya duty. Therefore, he is admitting, yes, katpanna duso apahatas sabhav. My natural duty I am forgetting. Therefore, I have become miser. Therefore, when you become miser, that is a disease condition. Then what is your duty? Then go to a person who can, just like when you become diseased, you go to a physician and ask him, what to do, sir? I am not suffering with this disease. This is your duty. Similarly, when we are perplexed in our duties, or we forget our duties, it is very nice to go to the superior person and ask him what to do. So who can be superior person than Krishna? Therefore Arjuna says, Prichyami Tma, I am asking you. Because it is my duty, I am now falling in my duty, faulty. So this is not good. So I must ask somebody who is superior to me. That is the duty. Tad vijnanartham sa gurumeva abhigacchet. This is the Vedic duty. Everyone is perplexed. Everyone is suffering in this material world, being perplexed, but he will not search out a bona fide guru. No. That is katpanna dosha. That is katpanna dosha. Here Arjuna is coming out of the katpanna dosha. How? He is asking Krishna, Prichyami tvam. My dear Krishna, you are the most superior person that I know, your Krishna. So I am perplexed. Actually, I am forgetting my duty. Therefore, I am asking you. So you have to approach the Supreme Person, means Krishna or his representative. All others are rascals and fools. If you approach a person, Guru, who is not representative of Krishna, you are approaching a rascal. How will be enlightened? You must approach Krishna or his representative. That is one. Tad vijnanartham sa guru meva vigacche. So, who is Guru? Samit prani sutriyam brahmanishtam. A Guru is full Krishna conscious, brahmanishtam. And sutriyam. Sutriyam means who has heard, who has received knowledge by the Srutriyam Partha, by hearing from superior authority, evam parampara praptam, imam rajal sayogidu. So here we have to learn from Arjuna that when we are perplexed, when we forget our real duty, and therefore we are puzzled, then our duty is to approach Krishna as Arjuna is. So if you say, where is Krishna? Krishna is not there, but Krishna's representative is there. You should approach him. That is the basic intention. Tad vijnanartham sa guru meva vigacche. One must approach Guru. And Guru means Krishna, originally. Guru, tene brahma rida adhikavaye, muhyanti jasuraya, janma adhasya jataha, annayatitadatascha arthesu avignasara. You have to approach. That is Guru. So we consider, we take Brahma, because he is the first creature within this universe. He is accepted as the Guru. He imparted, just like we belong to the Brahma Sampradaya. There are four sampradayas, Brahma Sampradaya, Sri Sampradaya, Rudra Sampradaya, and Kumara Sampradaya. They are all Mahajana. Mahajana Jena Gatasya Pantha. We have to accept the line of action which is given by the Mahajan. So Brahma is Mahajan. You'll find Brahma's picture with Veda in his hand. He gave the first instruction of Veda. But where from he got the Vedic knowledge? Therefore Vedic knowledge is apaurusha. It is not man-made. It is God-made. Dharmanta sakshat bhagavat pranita. So how God, Krishna, gave to Brahma? Tene Brahma rida. Brahma means the Vedic knowledge. Shabda Brahma. Tene, he injected Vedic knowledge from Hida. Tisam satat yuktanang bhajatang prithibhuta. When Brahma was created, he was perplexed. What is my duty? Everything is dark. So he meditated and Krishna gave him knowledge that your duty is this. You do like this. Tene Brahma rida adikavaya. Adikavaya. Brahma is adikavaya. So actual guru is Krishna. And here Krishna is advising the Bhagavad Gita, these rascals and fools will not accept Krishna as guru. They will go to some rascal and fool and miscreants, sinful person, and accept guru. How you can be guru? So guru is Krishna. Here is the example given by Arjuna. Prichyami tma, who is that man? Krishna. Why you are asking me? Dharma sangamura chita. I am bewildered in my duties. Dharma. Dharma means duty. Dharmanta sakshat bhagavat purna. Sangamura chita. So, what I have to do? Jat shreya. What is actually my duty? Shreya. Shreya and prayer. Praya, there are two things. Praya means which I like immediately. Very nice. And Shriya means ultimate goal. There are two things. Just like a child wants to play all day. That is childish nature. That is Shriya. And Praya means he must take education so that in future his life will be settler. That is Praya. Shreya. So Arjuna is asking not prayer. He is asking instruction from Krishna, not for the purpose of confirming his Shreya. Shreya means immediately he was thinking that I shall be happy by not fighting, not by killing my kinsmen. That he was like a child he was thinking. Shreya. But when he came to his consciousness, not actually consciousness, because he's intelligent. He is asking for prayer, shreya, jat shreya, syat. What is actually my ultimate goal of life? Jat shreya, syat. Jat shreya, syat, nishchitam. Nishchitam means fixed up, without any mistake. Nishchitam. In Bhagavad there is called nishchitam. Nishchitam means you haven't got to make research. It is already settled up. This is the decision. So because with our teeny brain, we cannot find out what is the actual nishchitam fixed up shreya. That you do not know. That you have to ask from Krishna. God is represented. These are the things. Jatshevasyat nishchitam bruhi ton me. Say, kindly, speak to me that. So why shall I speak to you? And here says, Shishasteham. Now I am accepting you as my guru. I become your shishya. Shishya means, whatever you say, I will accept. That is shishya. The shishya word comes from shasdhatu. Shasdhatu. Shastra. Shastra. Shasam. Shishya. These are from the same root. Shasdhatu. Prastatu means rule, ruling. So we can rule in various ways. We can be ruled becoming a shishya of a proper guru, that is sastra. Or we can be ruled by shastra, weapon. Just like a king has got weapon. If you don't follow the king's instruction or government instruction, then there is police force, military force. That is shastra. And there is shastra. Shastra means book. Scripture, just like Bhagavad Gita. Everything is there. So we must be ruled either by shastra, shastra, or guru, or becoming shishya. Therefore it is said, shishastiham, I become voluntarily, I surrender unto you. Now you become shishya, what is the proof that you have become my shishya? Shadhimam swang prapannam. Now I am fully surrendered. Prapanna. So this knowledge required. How to find out real guru and how to surrender unto him. The guru does not mean that I keep a guru as order supplier. My dear guru, I am suffering from this. Can you give me some medicine? Yes, yes, take this. Yes. Not that good. If you are suffering from some disease, you go to a physician. It is not guru's business to give you some medicine. Guru's business is to give you Krishna. Krishna says, Tomar Krishna dite par. Vaishnava is praying Guru. Sir, you are devotee of Krishna. You can give me Krishna, if you like. This is the position of shishya. Guru's business is how to give you Krishna, not any material things. For material things there are so many in institution. But if you want Krishna, then Guru is required. Who requires a Guru? Tasmad gurum prapadita jignyasu sreya uttamam sabde parechanishnatam brahmani upasamasrayam. Who requires a guru? Guru is not a fashion. I have got a guru. I shall make a guru. Guru means one who is serious. Tasmad gurum prapadita. One has to seek out a guru. Why? Jignyasu sreya uttamam. One who is inquisitive and the supreme. Not guru make a fashion, just like we keep a dog fashion. Similarly, we keep a guru. That is not guru. Guru will act according to my decision. Not like that. Guru means one who can give you Krishna. That is guru. Krishna says tomar, because Krishna is guru. That is stated in the Brahma Sangita. Bede sudurlava, adurlava apu bhaktau. Bede sudurlava. If you want to search out, although Vedas means knowledge, and the ultimate knowledge is to understand Krishna. Bede sudurlava, aham eva vidyam. This is the instruction. So, if you independently want to study, Vedas, there are some rascals. They say that we understand only Vedas. And what do you understand Vedas? I will understand Vedas. So Vedas says tad vijnanatham sa guru meva gacche. You will understand Vedas by taking one, purchasing one Vedas book or taking it, you will understand Vedas. Veda is not so cheap thing. Without becoming a brahmana, nobody can understand a Veda. What is Veda? Therefore it is restricted. Without becoming brahmana, nobody is allowed to study Vedas. It's all nonsense. What we will understand about the Vedas? So therefore, in order to achieve the highest goal of life, one should fully surrender to Krishna or his representative, then his life is successful. Thank you very much.